about the meaning beyond these words. We are caught in an inescapable network of mutuality, tied to a single bargain of destiny. What affects one directly affects all indirectly. As long as there is poverty in the world, no one can be totally healthy. And strangely enough, I can never be what I ought to be until you are what you want to be. And you cannot be what you want to be until I am what I want to be. You see, true words cannot be uttered to our current times. The assassination attempt on the former president by a 20-year-old kid who was practically still a teenager, his name Thomas Matthew Crooks. After more than 1 week, the FBI has yet to discover a motive. But there is no motive. Apparently, Thomas was subjected to relentless bullying by his peers in high school, was known as the loner, often referred to as the school shooter, because he had threatened to shoot up high school 5 years ago. Nonetheless, Thomas managed to graduate with honors from his community college with an associate's degree in engineering science. He worked at a local nursing home with no disciplinary issues. In fact, the investigation of Thomas' cell phone showed a previous internet search for symptoms of a depressive disorder, and also a search for images of both former and current presidents. Thomas' father called the police before the rally, concerned about his whereabouts. But the gun he used was a semi-automatic AR-style rifle, which was purchased legally in 2013 and registered to Thomas. The tragedy left one person dead and three others wounded. See, I would like to say that it should be known that the Church of Jesus Christ has been gathered to respond to the cries of injustice. That there is no room for evil. What is wrong is wrong. What is evil is evil. And Thomas' attempt to assassinate the former president is wrong. It is evil. It is incongruent with the language of the scriptures. But still, I pray for Thomas' family. I pray for the former president, for his family, and for recovery, and for the family affected by such a tragedy. Take words, take language, racist rhetoric, falsehood, a mentality of us versus them, a spirit of fear and exclusion will most certainly produce and provoke hateful acts, acts that are somehow deriving from fear and anxiety. Thomas was an educated boy, even an intelligent guy, seemingly quiet, but in trouble, bullied, rejected, and outdated. Perhaps his fear and his terror within overwhelmed him. But what does it say about our humanity? Okay, I am merely a pastor, priest, a theologian, all these things as well, but I'm also a father, a husband, a son, a brother, a friend, a student, a teacher, a person. I'm well aware of my partnership with the divine, with neighbor, with all creation. These kinds of things are sort of part of my role. It's sort of what I need to do is to interpret, to translate, to discern the happenings of our world through the lens of the scriptures, through the lens of the creator and keeper and sustainer, and pray about such things and ask that they lie about such things. I've been doing that for the past 3 years. This is what I came up with. See, I am convinced that Thomas. It's loved by God. I'm convinced that our former president is loved by God. That those on both sides of the aisle are loved by God. And that that God does not hate anyone, does not exclude anyone. And despite all our failures, mistakes, and transgressions, God still loves us. it's true. We are capable of sweet goodness and yet capable of destructive evil simultaneously, saints and sinners. As our Lutheran imagination. I'm certain about this. There is something greater than our country's politics, something higher than our U.S. economy and our financial concerns, something about the office of the president or some set of Supreme Judges. If there is something that surpasses our fears, something that overcomes gun violence and racism and sexism and homophobia, transphobia and xenophobia and any injustice over any evil fortune, that is the show. It will locate us, just like Jesus found his terrifying disciples. And in the midst of our fears, somehow he gets into our locked rooms, stands before us, and says, Shalom, peace be with you. Be whole, for I am whole. Look at my hands, look at my side. I am with you, for you are with you. Someone is with you. Jesus says to us this morning, nothing can separate you from my love. Receive my bread. Receive the Holy Spirit. The same breath that made Adam a living being. That breath fills the room. That peace fills this room. Fills our hearts, our minds, and our souls. Jesus, breathe into you. We are not alone.